So yesterday we had discussed about the different types of plants, the classification of the plants, and we studied that how plants are classified on the basis of their shape and size, and on that basis we have studied about the herbs, we have studied about the shrubs as well as that of the trees, we studied about the different characteristics of the herbs, shrubs and trees, as well as how the herbs, shrubs are differ from each other, or the shrubs and trees are differ from each other. Now today we will start with the other topic, and that is the climbers and creepers. You see, these are also a type of plant. So when we talk about the climber, so the name by the climber, you are able to understand that the thing or the plant which climbs up. Okay, so you can say these plants, they take support on the neighboring structure and they climb up. Okay, so the name is climber, it means the plant, they climbs up. So is it possible for the plant to climb up without any support? No. Okay, so we can say that these plants are, they take the help of the neighboring plant or neighboring rod or any kind of a neighboring structure by which they climbs up. So basically, the plant which belongs to the climber, or which we call is the climber, is actually having thin, long and that of the very weak stem. So you are able to understand that if suppose I am saying that the plant is a weak stem, it means that plant is not able to stand upright. Okay, so we can say the plants having thin, long, weak stem which cannot stand upright. Okay, but these plants, they rapidly climbs up with the help of the neighboring support or a tree. Okay, and that type of a plant is known as a climber plant. Okay, now see here, these climber plant, they are having a very special organ. Okay, so these special organ which is basically present in that of the climber, special organs, that special organs are known as tendrils. Okay, so these special organ, that is tendril. So what is the basic function of the tendrils? Tendril help in the climbing of these climbers, climber plant. Okay, so the tendrils, of climber plant, wind themselves around any neighboring plants or neighboring objects which helps to help plants to climb. So we can say that these climber plant, they are able to climb up just because of the presence of this special organ, that is tendril. These tendril help them to wind up. If suppose this is a support, a neighboring object is there, so these climber, they wind up around this neighboring object, and due to which they climbs up. Okay, so they roll themselves to the that of the neighboring object, or they climb themselves with that of the neighboring object and help them to move up. Okay, so these are the some of the characteristics of the climbers. Okay, so these are the climbers. Now, what are the different types of a climber? If we talk about the climber, so there are a lot of examples of the climber, like that of a beater guard. So you see, bitter gourd is Karela, or that of the bottle gourd. So bottle gourd is Lauki, or grapevine, or the very common plant that you can see at every home, money plant. Okay, so you see, these all plant, they are having very weak stem, but they are having a special organ, that is tendrils, and that tendrils help these plants to climb up, and that's why these different type of plants come in the category of climbers. Okay, so these are the climbers. Now we will come to the next one, and that is creepers. So creepers is very much similar to that of the climber, but there is a little difference between the climbers and that of the creepers. So first of all, we will see that what is creepers. So creepers are also a type of a plant. These plant also having a weak stem. Weak stem is there, and that since the stem is very weak, and you know, because of that it cannot stand upright. Okay, so to stand upright, the plant stem should be strong, and if the stem is not strong, then it cannot stand upright. Okay, and thus it spread on the ground. Okay, so we can say by this that these creepers, they are also having very thin, long and weak stem, and due to which they cannot stand upright. So as they cannot stand upright like that of a climber, so are they able to climb up? No, because you see here, the term is a creeper, creeping. Okay, so they spread on the ground. Instead of climbs up, they spread on the ground, and that's why the name is a creeper or the creeper plant. So we can define creepers, a plant having thin, long and a weak stem which cannot stand upright and spread on the ground is called creeper or creeper plant. Now see here, if we talk about the creeper, these creeper plant, they grow along the ground or with the any of the surface. And how they grow, that they used to now see, these creepers, they can grow along the ground, they spread themselves along the ground or with the any of the surface by extending their shoots, okay, by extending their long shoots as well as the, as they are extended themselves, it means what? They are spreading. And how they can spread? By branching themselves. As they branches themselves, then we can say that it will cover a big surface area. Okay, so it grow along the ground by extending their long shoot as well as by branching themselves. Okay, so these are the basic properties of the creeper. Now see, what are the different examples of the creeper? So watermelon or pumpkin or sweet potato or strawberry. So these are the examples of the creeper, and they used to grow along the ground by extending their shoots or by branching themselves so that they can grow. Now see here, these climbers and creepers, I think by the characteristic you are able to understand in both of the thing. The thing that is common, that is, these both are having very thin, long and weak stem. Both are having the thin, long and weak stem, and because of that they cannot stand upright. Okay, but you see that as they cannot stand upright, so these climbers, they climb up, but here they used to extend themselves on the ground only. One more thing, in the climber, you see they climb up because of a special organ, that is tendrils present in that of the climbers. But here in the creepers, there is no special organ or there is no such special organ present in that of the creepers. Okay, so tendrils is not present in the creeper, and due to which the creeper they used to spread themselves in the ground itself. Now we will talk about some of the differences which is between that of the creepers and the climbers. So if you see here, the creepers, they spread horizontally along the soil. Horizontally, it means it moves along horizontally along that of the soil. But here, the climbers, they grow erect when support is given. So you see it horizontally along the soil, it is talking about that it spread on the ground. It gets spread along the soil, on the soil or on the ground. That is the property of the creeper. But climber, as they get a neighboring support, the tendrils, they attach themselves to that of the neighboring support, and due to which they grow erect. Okay, or they climbs up, they rapidly climbs up. Next one, in that of the creeper, the fibrous root is developed at a nodal point for the support. So here a fibrous root is present. You should understand only thing that it is having the fibrous root, the creepers. Climbers, if we talk about, then it consisting of a tendril. Okay, so it is having a highly coiled tendril, and that tendril help in giving the extra support to that of the climbers so that they can stand upright or they can go, they can climb erect. So we can say that the basic two difference, the first one, it grow along the ground. Here it grow erect if it get any support. And the second one is that these creepers, they do not possess tendril, the special organ. But here in that of the climber, they are having a highly coiled tendril which help them to climb up. Okay, so this is the difference between that of the creeper and climber. Okay, student, we will come to the next topic, and that is the another part of the plant which we called as a root. So you all know about the root. So where is the root present? It is present at the base of the plant. Okay, so these roots are actually the base of the plant, and they are mainly present under the ground or inside to that of the soil. Okay. So the basic function of these root is that they hold the plant tightly. They hold the plant firmly so that plant can stand properly. Okay, so the roots, they are present inside the soil. They are present underground, and they help in holding the plant firmly in that of the soil. Okay, so we can also say that these root, they help in anchor the plant. Anchor, it means to keep the plant at a place. Okay, that is the meaning of an anchor. Okay, so these plants, they help in keeping the trees or the plant. These roots, they help the plant to keeping the plants at a place. Okay, so they'll help in anchoring, or they help in holding the plant firmly in that of the soil. Now after that, we will talk about the function of the root. So if you see the function of the root, then you find that the basic function of the root is to anchor it. Right now we had discussed about the anchor by that of the root. So you see here, these roots, they help to locate water, mineral. Roots permeate the soil, and in doing so, they anchor the plant in one place from its entire life. So you see, it is talking about that they help in locating the water where the water are present underground. They help in locating that of the mineral. by how actually the roots, they divided themselves into different branches, okay, and due to which they elongate themselves, you can say that they elongate as well as they branch themselves, and due to which this will help the root to locate water and mineral inside to that of the ground. But you see, these roots, although they branch themselves, they elongate themselves so that they see that of the place of water and mineral, but they help the plant to stand upright, or they help it plants to firmly attach with that of the soil so that the plant will remain at one place for entire life. Okay, so it will help in keeping the plant at a one place for a long time, as well as these help in locating the water and minerals which is present inside that of the soil. The next function of the roots, absorption. So you see here, the locate water or locate minerals. So you see, these root, when they locate water and mineral, they absorb the large amount of water and minerals or dissolved minerals which is present inside the soil or which is present in the soil. Okay, so the roots, they elongate themselves as they find the water, then they absorb a proper amount of water and dissolve minerals. So what kind of a minerals a plant or a root absorb? It may be nitrate, like in that of a leguminous plant. Leguminous plant, it means the pulses. Okay, so these are the nitrate, phosphate or sulfate. Student, don't get confused with these names, that phosphate or sulfate or nitrate. These are a kind of a element. Right now you understand that these kind of elements which is helpful, which is present in the form of minerals, and that plant, they absorb the mineral, and these minerals are very important for the proper functioning of the plant. Before that, in the human being also, you had discussed about the minerals. So we studied that iron or iodine or a calcium or phosphorus. These are the different kind of a mineral which is present, which we should take in our balanced diet. And if suppose we will not take such kind of minerals in our balanced diet, then it will cause a deficiency disease. And the same thing is with this plant also. They must take a proper amount of a mineral for proper functioning of the plant body. Okay, so how they absorb these mineral, how do they intake these mineral? With the help of the roots. So we can say that these roots help in the absorption of water, help in the absorption of the mineral from the soil. Now we will see the next function of the roots, and that is conduction. So see here, when we talk about the conduction of the water and minerals. So the first one we had discussed that how the roots, they elongate themselves, they branch themselves so that they get water. In the second, we talk about that this water that they locate, they how they absorb and that of the water and the mineral. And the second and the third one is the after absorption, there will be conduction. Okay, so conduction of what? Of the mineral and that of water. So these water and minerals which is absorbed by the root hair or the roots of the plant, now it will get moved or get conducted from one portion to the another portion of the plant. It means these water and minerals, they move upwards from the roots into the stem, the upper part of the root, that is the stem. And from stem, it reaches to that of the leaves, where these leaves help take the water and minerals in preparation of the food. Okay, so this is the third point, that is the conduction of the water and mineral. Fourth point is the storage. So these roots, they help in storing the energy reserves which is produced in the leaves of the plant via photosynthesis. So see here what happened, the water which get conducted from the root to the stem to that of the leaves. The leaves, they use that water to prepare the food, and now that food is distributed to the different parts of the plant. Okay, and the rest of the food or the extra food, it get reserved or it get stored in the roots of the plant. And that's why it said that the root, they store a large amount of energy reserve initially produced in the leaves of the plant via photosynthesis. Basically, you see, sugar or starch is, after photosynthesis, starch or sugar is produced. So this sugar, which is produced by the process of photosynthesis, it is stored in that of the root of the plant in form of starch. So the fourth function of the roots is storage. Then we will see the next one, and that is reproduction. So you see, reproduction, if you're talking about reproduction, so reproduction in some of the plant, it helpful in the reproduction also. So how they are work help in the reproduction of the plant. So if suppose we want to grow a two different type of a plant together, then we will take, if two plants are there, plant one and plant two. So if we want to tie these two plants together, then we will cut this, the stem of this plant or the upper part of this plant and the root of the second part of the plant, and finally we will combine these two different plants together. This is one and this is two. And so we can say that if, then what happened? The plant ultimately it grows up and it develops. Okay, so these roots from one plant and the shoot, the upper part except that of the root is known as shoot of the other plant, they tie up together and which help in the reproducing or which help in the formation of a new plant. Okay, so these roots are also help in the production or help in the reproduction of the plant. And different function of the roots are, it help in giving support, it help in anchor to that of the plant. The second one, it help in the absorption of the plant. Third one, it help in conduction of the water and mineral from one part of the plant to the other part of the plant. Then from the roots to that of the shoot. Then storage, the food, extra food, extra sugar, it is stored in the root in the form of starch. Starch means carbohydrate. Okay, it help in some of the plant, it help in the reproduction. It is a kind of artificial reproduction, as well as some of the roots are there which help in performing the photosynthesis. So these are the function of roots. Now we will talk about the different types of our root, students. So see here, the root, we had all studied about the function of the root and what is root. Now we will talk about the different plants, they have a different types of a root also. So basically the roots are classified into two, that is the tap root and the second one is the fibrous root. So we will start with the tap root. Tap root in a plant, tap root system is the very largest, central and most dominant root from which other roots sprout laterally. So we can say that in this root, a straight tapering root grows vertically downward. You can see this is a straight tapering root is going vertically down into that of the soil. And from this main root, the other branches from the different sides starts coming out. Okay, so it means it is having one main root This is the main route, which is going vertically downward. And from this central dominant route, the other different types of a route, they sprout laterally, or they comes the smaller route, they come from the sides of this main route. So we can call these type of a route as a side route. So you see in this picture, there is a main route and a lateral roots are there, which is coming out from this main route, that is the dominant or the top route. When we talk about the top root itself, it is quite thick, as well as it is quite thick. But you see, the lateral roots, they are very thin, much thinner than that of the top root. So we say that top root, which is the one only, which is the main root, is basically it is a thicker one, while the branches, the lateral root, which is coming out of this top root, is the thinner one. The different examples of the plant which possess this top root are pea plant, or neem, or mango, tulsi, carrot, radish. All these are the examples of the top root. So these are the examples of the plants which possess top root. Now we will come to the second type of a root, that is a fibrous root. The term is fibrous, okay, which appears like a fiber. So you can say that these root system is usually formed by a thin, moderately branching roots which is growing from the stem. Or we can say that these root, it mainly consisting of a thin fiber-like a root, which all are having almost the similar size, and that is known as the fibrous root. So basically, what is there in the fibrous root, that these fibrous root, they spread out into the soil, and there is no main root like that in the case of a tap root. All the roots in the thin roots, they come from the same point, okay, and from there they spread out into the soil, and which help in giving a good support to the plant, okay. So you can see here, tap root, they are having a main root and a lateral root are coming from that of the main root. But here there is no main or a lateral root. This all come from the same point in the form of a thin and a fiber-like a root, which is having almost the similar size and spread into that of the soil. Example of the plants which is showing these kind of roots are paddy, that is rice, or maize, or grass. If you uproot a root, then the grass which you had uprooted, you see the roots of that grass, it will be like that of the fibrous root, which is having a point from where the different fibers of the root come outward. Okay, so grass, paddy, maize, sugarcane, sweet potato, or bamboo, these all are the examples of the fibrous root. Now we will see the difference between the tap root and that of the fibrous root. So see here, student, if you see the first difference between the tap root and the fibrous root, so you see here, the tap root has only one main and long root, and the smaller root that grow from the main root are called lateral root. So you see, the tap root is having only one kind of a root, and that root is known as a main root or the dominant root. And from this main root, the other small root starts coming out. So if suppose this is a main root, so other small lateral root starts coming out from this main root. So this is the property of a tap root. But if you see in case of a fibrous root, so there is no main root. All the roots, it seems to be similar, and these all come from the same point only. Okay, so this is an example of a fibrous root. If you see the tap root, there is a main root, there is a dominant root, and that dominant root, it goes deep into the soil. Okay, but here the fibers like root are there, very thin roots are there, so they get spread, but these roots, they do not go deep into the soil. If you see the tap root, they are basically found in the plant which is having the reticulate venation in the leaves, and here it is found in the plant which have the parallel venation in their leaves. Reticulate venation and parallel venation we will discuss when we will studies about the leaf and different types of venation. Till that, you will understand the main difference between these two, that one is having the lateral root and a main root. Here there is no main root or a lateral roots are there, all root come from the same point. Here, since it is having a dominant root, that root will go deep inside to the soil, but here it is having a thin fiber like a roots, so they get spread over a certain area, but they do not go deep into the soil. So this is the basic difference between that of the tap root and fibrous root.